Hello, Apple Valley High School Fab Lab students. Today, what I'm going to show you is how to prepare a piece of material for cutting with our desktop mill. So the piece that I'm going to use is what we are going to be creating for this first assignment. And the dimensions are, it's 135 millimeters along the long edge. So I'm going to call that the X axis. And then on the Y axis, it's 76 millimeters. And then on the Z, the height, it's 18 millimeters. So when you're designing, you gotta make sure that the material that you use is actually going to be bigger than your design. So in your design file, you have to have it much smaller than that. And I will go through that when we look at setting up for printing. The first thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna mark the center of this because the machine starts cutting from the center out. So the center point is gonna be the middle. So what I'm gonna do is take my straight edge and just draw a line on the material. And you usually you wanna use pencil. Most of the time the stuff gets cut away, but you want it so that it's something that you can leave a mark, but get rid of it later. And then I'm gonna do this second two corners, and then where they meet, their intersection should be the very center of the block. So that's our intersection point. I'll mark that with a Sharpie so you can kind of see it a little better. And that's what I'm gonna use when I'm centering this when it's in the machine. The next thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna take some Turner's tape, and this is used for holding materials on lathes. So it's a really sticky tape. It's two-sided, so I've peeled off a little bit of the back, and I'm gonna make some slices on that so that I can cut it off. And then I'm gonna really, you want this to not move. One of the biggest issues we have with this machine is that the material doesn't stay stuck. I've made a jig to hold things pretty tight, but we're not going to be using that jig for this. We're going to just use the tape, and hopefully the tape will hold it in place. And I'm going to actually make a couple different setups with the same basic design so you can see how the machine runs differently. And that's what we're gonna look at next. So I'm gonna pause this, we'll bring it over to the machine, and then we're gonna put this into the machine. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna place our block on the build plate, but I wanna make sure that it's parallel to this front edge. So I'm gonna look at this front edge and really try to line it up so it's nice and parallel. And that looks pretty good. And then I'm just gonna push it down hard onto the material like that. And that looks pretty good. I think it's gonna be pretty centered. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn on the machine and then turn on the software that runs the machine. So I'm gonna probably record that and then also have this recording so you can kind of see what both things are doing at the same time. I'm gonna take out my flashlight. We'll probably need that to center things. So I'll probably be using that as well in a minute. And I'm gonna pause it again to get things set up. Okay, so what we're gonna do now is turn on the machine. And it takes a little minute to boot up. And then what I'm gonna do is open up the software that runs the machine. And that's called vPanel for SRM-20. The first thing that we wanna do is we wanna get our drill bit, so the bit right in the center. So I'm actually gonna move it by hand. So I can change the how many steps. So I'm gonna start with continuous. and at the same time, I'm going to be watching where that is on the machine. And a lot of times what I do is I'll use a flashlight so that I can kind of see what's going on. Because it's really hard to get this lined up. And then I'm going to change to 10 for the step process, because then it moves much more slowly. And you want this to be just above the plate, or the part that we're going to cut into. So I'm going to use that piece of paper. And if this barely moves, then it's at the right height. And you can see it's starting to hit the paper now. So I might go one more step down. It's actually a step of 10, maybe one more. You have to have the lid closed when you do this or it won't move. It's to protect us. So that looks pretty good. Yeah, it's barely coming out. And you notice it's not quite centered. So I'm gonna move it a little bit. I gotta lift it up just a little bit so I can move it. And that looks pretty good. And then I'm gonna drop it down. I moved it up a couple so I can barely get this through. That looks pretty good. So now what I can do is I have to tell the machine and the software that that's my zero. So right now it's not quite zeroed, so I'm gonna go over here. I'm gonna set my origin point, and I want to do that. So those change to zero, and then I also wanna change the Z height to zero. So now that's all set. So now I'm good to go. So what I can do now is open up the software to prepare the file for printing. And that's called SRP Player. And once that opens, what I can do is I can bring in my STL file. So I'm gonna open the file up that I created. And the first one that I wanna do is the cutaway one. So we're gonna actually cut away the material. So I'm gonna open that up. I want to show you different ways of doing this because you get different effects. Now, what I told you earlier, my block was 130 by 70 by 19, but the original dimensions I showed you were 135 by 76 by 18. So we had to make it a little smaller to make sure that everything would fit. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna kinda cheat on the machine. I'm gonna uncheck this. I'm gonna change that to 17 because I don't want it quite that tall. And then we're gonna cut from the top. So I'm gonna leave that. The type of milling we're gonna do is faster. We have lots of flat planes and we're gonna only cut from the top. You can also cut from another side so you can rotate it after it does its cut. For creating the tool path, first thing it wants is the actual block size. So you see that it wants to have a block bigger than what I've told you. So I'm gonna just put those default numbers in, and then what it'll do is it'll actually mill off of the block, which that doesn't really matter. But the height is really crucial. If we go down too far, it's gonna cut into the build plate. We don't wanna do that. So that's why I made my Z height a little bit less than the actual. So that looks good. I'm gonna move the start point to the top of the block so it doesn't mill in the bottom. And then under the tool path, before you create it, you want to look at what type of bit you have. So I opened up the roughing, and that's
the eighth inch carbide flat bit that I have in there, so that's good. The same thing with the finishing. It does a roughing cut and then a finishing cut, and we're not going to change the bit, so I'm going to keep those the same. So I'm ready to create my tool path. So it's creating now. It does the roughing tool path and then the cutting one. Once it's finished, then what I can do is preview it. And I want to show you the preview, because when I bring in the other ways for cutting these, you get different results. You always have to be aware of the size of the tool bit, because if you're, what you're cutting is too big, the tool bit, or too small, the tool bit won't cut it. So I'm going to preview this. It's going to take 0.8 hours, about 50 minutes. So it's going through and creating that profile. You notice we put in dimensions that are a little bit bigger, so it thinks that it's going to leave some stuff here, but that'll all be gone. So that looks good. I'm happy with that. So we're ready to cut it, so I can perform cutting. You can also output it to a file. This tells you how tall your bit needs to be. It needs to be at least 18 millimeters tall, and ours is about 25 or 30, so we're good for that. So I can hit start cutting. We centered it, so it's all centered where it needs to go. It kind of reminds us to put in the correct tool, and we have that. We're starting at the center. So I can hit next, and now I'm gonna start cutting. And then you notice that it spins up to the correct rotational speed, and then it's going to come down and start cutting. And the first cuts are a little bit above where it needs to be, because we had it the width of that paper. And now it's starting to cut into it. That looks good. So I switched over to the other software so you can see what the machine is doing. And it shows the depth that it's cutting, it shows the rotational speed, and its travel speed. And it's going to continue to run for about 50 minutes. So I'm going to actually pause this now.